Hello and welcome back once again to Viking Whiskey. Today it's 10-year-old Aeloin. This one was bottled by Scotch Malt Whiskey Society. The name of this one is Cherry Blossom Petit Four. Sounds sweet. Let's see. Bottled at 56.4%. Details are on the screen right here. All right, here we are. Very light color. I mean, could even have your doubts if this is actually whiskey. very light. Let's see. Oh, definitely something creamy in there. There's whipped cream. There's butter. There's some notes of sawdust. There's hay and light varnish. There's something slightly yeasty, like a dough for a bread. And there's definitely also some tea, flower tea. Tea and yeast and butter and cream, sawdust. It's a very different nose for sure. See what it tastes like. It's quite light in the mouth. Very light, actually. There's a lot of honey. It's the first thing you get. And then, on top of that, quite a lot of wood spices. It's more sweet than bitter. But it's really this honey sweetness. And some notes of freshly cut grass come out with a lot of juicy bitterness. Odd one. In the second chew, a lot more perfumed notes join in. There's a lot of toffee coming on here. Also something like rose petals. There's even some fragrant olives. Some more black pepper coming on here as well. I have to say it's a bit of an odd mix. Last one. Here in the third chew, it does get a little more powerful in the expression, slightly drier. There's also a lot of, what is that flavor? I think it's still this honey, but then you also have some caramel. Chestnuts, this chestnut cream is exactly it. That's what I was looking for. There's walnut liquor, plum jam. Those are actually some quite nice flavors. So here in the third chew, it's actually finding its place. It's a lot better than it was to begin with. But it took a little while to get there. On the finish, it comes down rather quickly. It's really fairly short. The burn is gone. So what you're left with is semi-dry. It's leaves you notes of coffee, dark chocolate, honey. Some of this chestnut cream still there. And a little bit of this grass juice bitterness also. But it is quite short. So, rating this fella. The nose was a bit too weird for me. I don't think anybody would say it's a great nose. It's a 73. Taste-wise, it started off too simple and a bit strange, but ended up on actually quite a nice flavor. Definitely different. So, taste-wise, 78. The finish is really too short. There's already basically nothing left of it. But it was all right when it was there. So, 75. So, that would give us an average of 75. Perfect. Thank you so much for watching. As always, I do hope to see you on the next one. Cheers.